Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here at the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance Series. Happy Friday, Mosh Pit. Happy holiday, Christmas weekend. I hope you all are having a great start to it. Hopefully, you're celebrating with friends and loved ones, and you're just having a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays from me to you. Thank you very much for being a part of the Mosh Pit and supporting my channel. I really appreciate it. It keeps me going, keeps us doing what I love doing. So here's your meme of the day here. This one, it's a little bit dated in case you missed the massacre that was, but Heavenmail salute and thank you to Ranksrod for this gem of a day. Title thread was Bombastic Friends. All my friends are dead. Transformed into Bombs Edition. Yeah. So we found out that apparently if you use Friend Finder and then use one of the ace items, one of the ace of spades or clubs, they all get converted, even though they're on your side and were summoned by Friend Finder. So thank you very much, Ranksrod, and everyone who upvoted that one. It's going to be three Hotel Romeo, Hotel X-Ray, Papa Papa, Foxtrot. We've got god-awful movement speed. Decent tiers again and decent damage again as well. So I'm like, you know, it's kind of like yesterday's run where we just had like a great start but never really got like rolling. I mean, we had a couple of marquee items, but nothing incredibly major, I would say. I'm trying to get this bomb fly over here, or bomb spider rather. There we go. Also start off with Yuckheart and also Navi, who is going to show us where tinted rocks are, as well as crawl spaces and secret rooms, all that kind of good stuff. Going to kick it off here with a D-Twanky, just because the D-Twanky is just way better than Yuckheart. Also have the Broken Syringe, which did briefly give us Roid Rage or Speedball. I couldn't tell which one it was. And you know what? Let's just get a little spicy with it. Okay. All right. Well, I mean, we got 5 cents out of it thanks to that bomb, so maybe it was worth it. I'm not entirely sure. That one there was. I think that one was. That looked like growth hormones. No. That was synth oil because it was range. It was range and something else. This time we have the virus, as you can tell by the contact damage of the poison on the little eggies. Okay. Wow. Getting a bunch of extra stuff at the beginning here. That may have been a better D20 room. Really depends if there's a full charge in here. There's not, but thanks to all of the money that we've gotten, we can get an early PhD, which would be huge. Huge, huge, huge. And we do get a charge key in here, so I could have re-rolled that stuff. I'm glad I didn't, though. The D20 is going to re-roll all pickups on the ground into other random pickups. And it is it's a strong item. It's not one of those items that you really consider too much in terms of like power, but it can start snowballing out of control very quickly. If you don't have any need for like money or keys or bombs, that sort of thing, the D20 can be very, very, very useful. Might D20 this room here, maybe not. Let's see what we get inside of this super secret room. This is most likely going to be a better candidate for the D20 room. Now, you will see me going after the demon fires here first. And I'm not actually sure if they're called demon fires. Just call them demon fires. But instead of me wasting bombs here, which is going to cut into our possible profits that we can make with the D20, instead I'm going to go ahead and just push both of the stone chests over to the pushable barrel. Although I could have used any of the other barrels, but it's just, I was going in that direction. It's just easier. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bust open all of these fires here, and that's because they could drop coins, which, again, we're looking for fodder here to give us more things to re-roll with the D20. So here we go. The Bone Heart is acceptable. The Strength card is also acceptable, considering that we're probably going to get a Devil Deal. I didn't actually mean to pick up that penny, because we could have picked these up over here. And I'm going to grab the Charge Key, which is going to give us a full charge on the D20. Now that we have a red heart, we can now use for possibly the sack room if these turn into red hearts, and they don't, although we do get a golden chest, which does give us some red hearts. Okay. Okay. All right now. So you're seeing a little bit of potential here with the D20 giving us some possible reroll stuff, along with having a shot at the sacrifice room here. D20 showing up big here. I'm going to hold on to the Strength card to make sure that we have something to go on for the Devil Deal on the next floor, but it is possible we could come away on this floor with having an Angel item or possibly even a Devil Deal. So Pink Haunt, this is one of the few haunts that you want to do something that you should never do against any other haunt that stand right in front of it, because that split Brimstone will actually hit you if you're not directly in front of him. We get a Cat of Nine Tails and another Soul Heart. My goodness. Okay, so I'm gonna take this as a sign, and we're gonna go ham on this. We're about to go absolutely nuts on this secret sacrifice room. And I may even consider using the strength card here as well. The PhD gave us a full heal on the Bone Heart, and this is gonna take a while, but it's gonna be worth it. So we're gonna go back over here. We're not gonna pick up the double heart yet. Because it is possible we may get an HP upgrade here. Most likely, we'll still stick with everything. We'll just keep everything that's inside of that room. But we do have the strength card, which would allow us to get another tap on the sacrifice room if we actually needed it. But right now, keeping this bone heart going is very, very important. We are going to lose the bone heart, most assuredly. But the amount of help that it can get us here and get us to possibly the end, or at least the seven soul heart payout of the sacrifice room, is extremely important. I'm going to go over here. We're going to pick up this other one. We also got the puberty pill, which we are not going to care about. Okay, now we have a 50% chance for a random chest, and this is going to take a while, so I don't mind if you guys and gals out there in the mosh pit decide to hit fast forward on this or play it 2x. I know a lot of people like to do that. We're not going to re-roll this because we're not going to get any more charges, so I might as well just pick it up now. But the D20 just giving us so much potential here. And we are going to start losing these soul hearts. I purposely left that soul heart in the boss room for a very good reason, which you'll see as we leave this floor. Okay, we have a 33% chance to get teleported to the angel room. Okay, now we have a 33% chance for a angel room item. Got a soul heart. Now we get the troll bombs. I was hoping that we're going to get another soul heart there from the bombs. I don't actually really want to fight Uriel here. You saw the euthanasia shots. That was coming out of thanks to the broken syringe, which can give you any random amount. It can give you a random syringe item. We want to try to play around the spikes here, as Uriel cannot fly over them. Neither can Gabriel. That's one thing we don't want, though, is we do not want to take damage against him. There we go. So we get an Angel of Teal piece here. Yeah. I don't think there was a full charge. Anyway, the moral of the story is that hopefully, maybe, no. The moral of the story here is that what I was hoping for... I would have bought this, by the way, to see if it was a 48 RNG pill. The moral of the story is that what I was hoping for was to get a full charge and then re-roll the 30 cents or possibly the 7 soul hearts. Obviously, I would have most likely kept with the 7 soul hearts, but had we gotten the 30 cents there, that would have actually given us a little bit more of a reason to re-roll other stuff, like go in there and drop some trinkets, that sort of thing. So I'm actually going to go back and get the strength card because I think it's a little bit better. And then, of course, we leave the soul heart behind in the boss room. So in case we did get an HP upgrade or an eternal heart, we can protect it going on to the next floor. So very, very long first floor, but it sure was worth it. Eat Twankie, let's go. All right, we are gamifying our Isaac strategies here. You know, we talk about profiting with the D20, making sure that we're getting more than we put in, and it's very easy to manipulate how many things you can reroll on a floor by simply just going over, picking up pills, picking up trinkets, dropping them on the ground in the same room, and then all of a sudden, you've got tons of D20 fodder. Look at that. There's a double tinted rock where Navi is. So you can tell it's a double tinted rock instead of a single tinted rock. If you look very carefully there, there's that dark X I was talking about a couple of episodes ago appearing on the left side instead of the right side of the rock. So it's going to take two bombs, which is always going to be worth it. Unless, of course, it gives you a golden chest, but then it gave us a damage upgrade. So joke's on us, I suppose. So Navi also showing us that the secret room is going to be in this room. And this is absolutely worth using a bomb or two to get in. I do want the luck upgrade, actually. I don't think I can get secret room and the bomb and the penny. Yeah, I'm not gonna do it in one. That's fine. Okay, full charge there. That's important. This full charge is very important for the D20. Just keep that in mind. I'm going to take the Sixth Sense here, and then we're going to go check out the item room. And it gives us rune bag, which potentially could give us more runes, more crap to throw on the ground to reroll. You never know. Look at this. We have no problem at all with consumables. We have no problems at all with the amount of money that we have. The world is our oyster right now. Super Secret Room is not to the left here. It's actually a little bit surprising. Okay, so this room here could potentially be the reroll room that we're looking for. Potentially. Not saying it is or not. We need to spawn more stuff. Now you may notice that these pots here, the pots also might be pretty worthwhile. We get a free lost contact, which honestly I'm not really that interested in right now. Our tears rate is not high enough for us to really warrant that. Now, there's another possibility here on this floor, and that is in the arcade. Of course, if we go tap a bunch of stuff on the Temperance Machine, or if we go play Three Skull Monty, that's potentially a ton of stuff on the ground that we could also reroll with the D20. Remember, we have that other reroll with the full charge that's sitting inside of the secret room right now. That was a bad angle on my part, so it deserved to be hit there. The luck upgrade here, as well as our soul heart back. Get Lusty Blood. Or Necronomicon. I'm going to go ahead and take Lusty Blood because it is a very nice damage upgrade that we can get. Even though it doesn't help us right now. It doesn't help us right now. It will help us with us killing enemies and stuff. So, and I'm just going to pick up these coins now because I think that the path to victory is going to be through the arcade over here. Hoping that there's a Three Skull Monty. We have plenty of money to play with. And hopefully we get a couple of winning draws. And we can go get a bunch of crap on the ground. Now, unfortunately, there's not a Temperance Machine in here. So here we go. We can also play the bomb beggar a little bit. So you see the strategies I'm talking about. It's nothing. We're doing nothing intricate, nothing super fancy, anything like that. We're simply just playing with what the game gave us. Look at that. Look at that. We can even get one of these bombs here, recycle it, put it with the bomb beggar. Maybe he gives us more stuff. You never know. Usually he likes to pay out with hearts and chests and stuff, so this one's being a little bit stingy now. We're getting lucky with the Three Skull Monty rolls, though. There we go. Now, I'm not going to sit here all day and do this, but this is worth it, though. With us having two, not one, but two rerolls with the D20, we want to get as much stuff as we can on the ground here. Play this down to 15. And trust me, we're going to get... We started with 40 cents and, you know, and I think three bombs. We're going to get a lot more than that after we're done here with the D20. We'll go to 15 cents just to put a limit on it. Notice how high our damage is getting now thanks to Lusty Blood. I actually followed that one with my eyes that time. That one too. Missed that one. One more. Okay. So now what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to pick up a couple of these, which is fine. Try to minimize the amount that we're picking up. And then go over here. And never mind. I, for some odd reason, thought that there was a soul heart in there. I guess we already bought that soul heart, never mind. Yeah, anyway, so let's re-roll this. Get a soul heart out of here, devil card, which would allow us to get into the that golden chest that's in that on that other side there. Now, I do want the soul heart, but I don't want the devil card necessarily. We could pick it up, though. Leave the other stuff behind here. And we're not going to be done. After we get this reroll, we're not done yet, because we can still go into our boss trap room and get some good value out of there, too. Oh, that's a lot of stuff on the ground. This also would have been a pretty decent room for us to use the E20 in. We're still going. I know it's taking a while, I know, but sometimes, you know, hey, sometimes you got to do it. If you want to really like squeeze the most the most beneficial effect out of the items that the game gives you, sometimes you got to do some big time plays like this. So, we get that. That's the reason why we wanted to get the Soul Heart here, was so we could play the Demon Judgment. I was hoping that he was going to pay out with something. We got a tower card, which is not going to help us. So we get little clot, which honestly is better than broken syringe. We can go check what's inside of the mob trap room, and we get a little squeezy. So squeezy is going to give us a much needed tears up and two soul hearts, which also prevent us from dying. So definitely worthwhile there. And of course, we got a little clot too. Clot gang. You all know the story by now. There we go. Chunking away. Now, I'm not saying that this is a pure min-max way to do things here, but this is a little bit more min-maxy than you all see me usually get. But I also wanted to highlight like how strong the D20 can be, and you know, see a golden opportunity to really get ahead in the game, and this is one way to do it. So now we have an eternal chest. We have a whole bunch of ways to open this up. Now we also have a full charge here too, which is also going to help us out even more. Thanks to us re-rolling everything that we see from these chests. With that, I'm not going to open up the mega chest yet, because chances are we're probably not going to get enough keys to feed it, but let's find out. It's a pretty horrible eternal chest. And we do get a Bloody Gust as well as Gimpy payout. Wow. Okay, so we have enough to re-roll stuff again. I'm going to drop the Temperance Machine. As well as a little clot, just to have more stuff to reroll. I mean, we can hold on a little clot. That's fine. We get a bunch of soul hearts here, and that's about all she wrote. So now we're not done yet here. We're still not done. We can play the Demon Judgment and hope for a payout. Gimpy can also prolong this as well if we get lucky enough. A strength card here, which we're just going to use. That's a tears up pill. That Gimpy giving us a soul heart, I tell you what. And we also get a caffeine pill, which gives us movement speed. Also is going to give us a verp, which gives us another tears up thanks to the verp. And that is that. So wow. Now I'm not saying you got to do that every single time you get the D20, but the results speak for themselves. Look how much more powerful we are. And I will take lost contact now, because we have a tears rate to back it up. All right, we really set the foundation for this run now. We put a lot of time into maximizing the potential for the D20, and, you know, this is the result. You know, now, again, I'm not going to do that on every floor. I just wanted to show you all, if you have to, especially if you have the D20, if you really have to hunker down and say, okay, we need to get HP, we need to get money, we need to get keys, this is the way to do it. The D20 is your gateway to so many different good things in a run. And we need keys here, so I'm going to grab this key. Also, try not to die. And I'm not going to use the D20 yet in here because, well, there's also potential for more stuff, as you see right there. Yeah, look at that. Now we're going to D20. We get a luck upgrade. Get a mimic chest, which we're just going to ignore. We got a sun card, which we can use right away.
The sun.
Yeah, we can open that. Why not? Gives us a little bit of a buff thanks to Bloody Gust. Nice block there by Shielded Tears. Another Yave. So now we still have our... We basically have our reroll room ready to go. There's a Tinted Rock. I thought I saw one. Go get our soul hearts back. No harm, no foul. We know that there's a boss room, or a mini boss room, I should say, over here, adjacent to the secret room. Thank you for watching, little Clot. Clot, Clotty, where are you going? And I found pills, which you don't care about. Taking a shortcut. We didn't have to bomb our way in here, but it just saves us a little bit of time. This level's already gotten very, very high. Get another tiers up here. I say level, but I mean the runtime. All right. So one more charge, and we can get ourselves another reroll. And oh my Gertie, we get ourselves Diplopia. Okay. The Diplopia is very interesting because we can use this here in the Devil Deal, or we could also Diplopia everything that we D20 in that room, which is not necessarily a bad idea, but I don't think it's worth it. And we're pretty soon not going to even have to worry about having the D20 anymore. We're about to have a whole bunch of stuff. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to drop the pills as well as our trinket. We're going to reroll it. Not great, but we'll take it. We're still way ahead of where we began with, what we began with. And I think we're going to go with Diplopia here, mainly because I want to take Devil Deals, but we don't have enough HP to really facilitate that. Go 29 cents, 10 bombs, 6 keys is a really good spot to be in. I don't know if you caught this or not, but did you notice that we still have a little Clot despite us rerolling the trinket? That's right. That is right, my friends. You can maintain little Clot as long as he doesn't die. You can keep him without even having the trinket. Isn't that cool? Isn't that neat? Now, I'm not saying he's going to live very long, but still, it's kind of neat that he's helping us for now. We'll get help from Bloody Gust, as well as Bloody Lust, and we get a Bone Heart. I want to use the Soul of Isaac on that, and also not going to use it on this because it's Krampus. Hopefully we get Lump of Coal. We do get Lump of Coal. Very nice. So, yeah. There's Darkness. Looking good, man. We're feeling good. It's Christmas weekend. 2 days of Christmas. Can you believe it? That's only like a week and then it's New Year's. Actually unreal. I gotta start thinking about taxes again soon, man. Where's the time go? So we could go in the curse room. I'm not going to right now. We get a planetarium. Interesting. Not sure what we did to deserve one, but hey, I'll take it. Especially if it's going to give us, like, hopefully give us Mercurius. Mercurius has been showing up a lot lately, actually. Venus wouldn't also be bad. And it's going to be Neptunus. I'm normally not a huge fan of Neptunus, only because of just how finicky it is. I don't like charge shots. But with Shielded Tears, especially with little Clot here, it is going to help us out greatly. As long as little Clot stays alive, that's the thing. Our Clot has to stay alive. So we get another sack room here. Already 21 minutes, we're on Caves 1. Yeah, it was a little long-winded on the D20 play, but hey, you know what? Like I said, sometimes I think of how much weaker we would be if we didn't use the D20 the way we did, you know? Get a Hwaz. A Hwaz is gonna give us a trap door if we use it on any art on the ground. Like a couple blades of grass right there. And we get D-Bizzle. D-Bizzle, heard we were talking trash about him. They've got a little rivalry now going on. I love the idea that D-Bizzle and Lost Soul Buddy now have a little friendly rivalry going. It's the Sasuke to the Naruto. Naruto. So we let Choop-de-whoop again. We can still clear with Shoop here. I don't mind that. But if it comes down dollars to donuts, we're gonna be holding on to Diplopia more than Shoop. So Neptunus, by the way, Neptune will give us a charge shot that loads up. It front loads a bunch of tiers. But obviously the tiers rate decays very, very quickly. Bizzle gives us an Emperor card. I see you trying, D-Bizzle. Trying real hard. That's what we need. I need a professional artist to depict D-Bizzle as Naruto and Sasuke as, or Lost Soul Buddy as Sasuke. There you go. There's your idea. There's your guaranteed meme of the day. Got to be good though. It can't be crap. See here, the burst damage from Neptune is just so strong. Pretty bad, going crazy with the souls. We don't want those. The stars card over here. Drowsy, experimental pill. These are always going to be a stat up. Got an HP up there. And a health up.
Health.
And another health up. Wow. Okay, so let's go back. We're going to go back and we're going to pick up Diplopia. I go all the way heck over here. It's probably easier if I just bomb my way through the arcade. But also give us access to the shop. We say thank you to Shoop the Whoop. I'm gonna touch the Bible here just to get the book touch. I'm not planning on keeping it though. Another tiers up here with divorce papers, but unfortunately we did not get a devil deal. So do we stick with the soul Isaac? Probably have to, just because we have the reroll and the Diplopia. Potentially more item pedestals to reroll. And I know. It may feel like a little sacrilege for me to forget, but for me to not take the Emperor card that D-Bizzle gave us. Not the personal D-Bizzle. No, you've been making big time plays here today, and I appreciate that. But right now, we're not in a situation where we can really hold on to a Emperor card for that long. You know, we need to think about the rerolls here for Deal with the Devil on this floor. We hopefully get. And look at, I mean, hey, Lil Clot still hanging in there. If Lil Clot survives past Lamb, you have to subscribe to my channel if you're not already. If you are, then you have to click the like button. How about that? I think that's fair. If I can keep Lil Clot alive past Lamb, like actually like beat Lamb and then like we go to the victory lap. That's the rule. That's the game plan. And if I fail, then you can say that I failed. That simple. It's win-win. How about this? If I fail, then you get to name Little Clot Buddy in the comments. Let me know what you want his name to be. Or her name to be. Gonna shoot a tier at us, which we have to be ready for. Purple fires, they only shoot one tier, so you don't have to worry about that after. Once it fires once, you can just dodge it. So the end. We don't want to fight the boss yet because we want to go find a keeper to blow up. Hey, look at how many bombs and keys we have. It's just so nice. Our battery is not going to do anything for us. Not with Diplopia anyway.
Experimental pill.
I don't know what experimental pill did. We're still looking for our item room. 26 minutes to mom is a that's a very, very, very long run, and we're not even to mom yet. Debizzle. Secret room's gonna be right there. Debizzle pays out with a speed up pill.
Speed.
We get another one here. And we also get a verp, which gives us another speed up. I actually don't really want to take it because I don't want another speed up. Skinny odd mushroom. We are already capped, so I don't think that that helps us that much. In fact, it exclusively hurts us, and it gives us a damage down. That's very tempting too. Adds Kizzle. Well, here's the hoping that we get a devil deal here. Go bomb the keeper. Okay, so what we're looking for here is a 73% devil deal. Yeah, we can take these. Some rotten hearts to work with. And we failed a 73% deal with the devil again. Womp, 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 womp. So for the second time in many days, the game makes us wait until 4, 5, and 6 before giving ourselves a deal with the devil. That's fun. Not to worry about blowing up the keeper this time because, well, we have a 100% deal with the devil. And you might be saying, Victor, can't fail 100% deal with the devil. Oh, well, that's where you're wrong, friends. You can indeed. I have indeed failed 100% deal with the devil. You might be saying, how? That's impossible. Well, if you have 100% deal with the devil, you gain guaranteed access to the devil room, and that is it. It does not guarantee you a devil deal item. You're like, wait a second, you getting the devil deal, that means you got a devil deal, right? I would disagree. I would say that if you walked into a devil deal room and you had no items in there to get, guess what? You got scammed, my friends. I would not call that having a devil deal. Fellas, some of you might think you have girlfriends out there. All right. They might be ones you play with online. But I hate to tell you, if you can't see them, they're about to I'm not even going to go there. I was going to do a make-believe girlfriend is just as bad as a 100% devil deal that you don't get an item with, but Punchline never really got there, so. Can use the Book of Revelations, even though it doesn't really matter because we're already full HP anyway. It's a very odd place for the Super Seeker room. Take an Eternal Heart. Well, we missed Boss Rush by a little bit. We also are going to miss Hush by a little bit. And we may not do a victory lap, but I will go fight Lamb no matter what. Because I said that I would. I'm gonna take Clot. I'm gonna take the Clot down to the Lamb just to see. We could potentially get some damage up here. I'm willing to go 3. I wanna go 4 because I wanna take a double deal. Also need to go back and find my. There it is. I was gonna say, where did that go? Okay, so we don't need to come back in here. We're pretty much good on everything. Let's see if our 100% devil deal make-believe girlfriend was worth it. Oh, come on. Gonna knock me from one into the other. Alright, gotta be very careful. Our movement speed's way too high. Get void. E-aw. Get a per throw. I'm gonna reroll that. We get sack altar. Oh no, avoided clot buddy. It wasn't supposed to do that. Oh, come on, Blizzard.
Soul of Isaac.
Oof. Well, thankfully we can take Athame along with Eye of Belial. I mean, Death's List is pretty tempting, but I do want Horror Babylon. I do want Death's Touch. And I didn't know it was gonna take Clot away from it. I thought it was gonna sacrifice Navi if anything. Oh well. Well, now you in the mosh pit down below, now you all get to name our little Clot friend. Forever. Forever they will be known as what? I'll pick the best name out there. Or maybe we can put it to a community vote. I don't know. What are we gonna name the clot? Whenever we see our little clot friends. Yeah, I'm actually gonna take Lard here because it does give us more HP. But more importantly, it slows us down a little bit. Even though 1.76 is not out of my tolerance, or it's just barely out of my tolerance, it's not really like having 2.0 movement speed. I'm sad that we lost our clot though, man. That was so good having the double Neptune effect. I'm bummed about that. Oh, now you know, word of the wise, if you have a clot friend and you use Sack Altar, be prepared to lose it. Our luck is out of control right now. Contract from below gives us a whole lot of nothing here. So, you know what? I'm going to be super lazy and save myself a little bit of time. Chances are we're going to get a red heart back anyway on the way to the boss room, so I don't feel too guilty about it. Oh my goodness. Look at all that. Well, we have 99 cents now, so Hush would have been like a not bad strategical... What health up pill is? Going to Hush would not have been a bad strategy. It's just that it just took so damn long in the second floor. Didn't really make much sense to keep going here. Look at that. Wow. Fame is just going absolutely bonkers on everything here. We got a shot speed and tears up, and we'll head on down. Friday. 2 days before Christmas. I'm really curious. Adults out there, do you still ask for Christmas presents? From like your family? Or are you like me and you just kind of, if you want something or need something, you just go out and get it when you need it? I'm notoriously difficult to buy gifts for. My family knows this. And they kind of don't like it, but I mean, that's just how I am. What's going on? Are you telling me there's crawl space over here? There is. Oh yeah, we don't have D-Bizzle anymore. I'm the type of guy who, if I need something, I simply just go out and get it. Or if I want something, I just simply go out and get it. I don't wait for like, well, I hope my mom gives me this for Christmas. You know, and I know that's not the best answer because obviously like, oh, you know, moms and dads, they want to feel like they're doing something special for their kid. And I'm down with that. Like, I love getting presents from my parents. It's just that I never ever think of anything that I want. I can't think of anything that I want. And like, no, like money is not like a good gift. I prefer, because I'm not good at giving thoughtful gifts. My gosh, we got two guppy items in here and we get a damage up. I almost got guppy. I'm not good at getting thoughtful gifts for, like, my family members. Now, girlfriends is different. Girlfriends, I try to put a lot of effort and thought into what I get them for Christmas or birthday or Valentine's or whatever. I like putting the thought there. But for family members, it's like I know what they like and appreciate. But sometimes I just don't have time to go to the places that I know that my family members shop or whatever, or I just like get lazy and I'm like, yeah, I'm not gonna do this. I'd rather just give them a gift card. I think that gift cards are better than cash always, because at least like it shows like the person like, hey, I know where you like to be, I know where you like to shop. I just don't know what you want this year from Academy or from like, you know, I don't know, like Olive Garden. Another tiers up here. We are super maxed out on tiers. So many health ups too. Up.
I can see forever.
But I will say that I think that you could potentially get one of those, like, you know, those gift cards, the sort of like the Visa cards that you just load up with like $100 or something like that. I think that those are okay, because it sets a limit on how much money you're giving someone. Plus, like, it's not cash. Like, that they can't use it for like gas or something like that. Like, you know, you give them like something that they have to buy. You know, make them work for it a little bit. You know what I mean? I think gift cards are a perfectly acceptable means of Christmas presents. I think it's better than cash. Zack Dagger, Ghost Baby. Some page number 2. Yeah, come on down, Ghost Baby. Why not? I'm just gonna use Pinking Shears against Monstro. And Athame is so powerful now, especially with 5.77 luck. That's gonna proc on anything that dies, and I mean anything. Fate's Reward, which is actually a pretty big pickup for us here. Actually, I take that back. No, it's not. It doesn't fire like our clot did. Back in the ancient times when Clot was still alive. Not sure what hit us in that second one there. Get Libra. I think Libra would be a mistake. I think Libra would give us a pretty big tears down. We don't really want that. But one thing I do want is for those of you who celebrate it to have a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. And thank you very much for making me a part of your life this past year or years. However long you've been watching the channel, everyone, I really appreciate it. And hope you all have a great start to your Friday. And also, of course, leave a comment down below on what you think the... Yeah, let's go fight him. We're not done yet. And Curse of the Blind. Only reason why I'm doing this, by the way, is because we have a... I thought Navi... Is she circling over there, or is that just... Okay. The reason why I'm doing this is because we have an Algis rune. You should never fight Delirium without having a Polaroid. Unless if you're just so powerful that it just doesn't matter. Which we are not in this room, in this run right now. We are not powerful enough to really face roll Delirium.
Experimental pill.
Getting a whole bunch of luck. Alright. be better if we had Guppy here. Obviously, with Curse of the Blind, we have no idea what we're going to be getting. But it's possible. You can get Guppy items from the bosses in Void, so... Here's the hoping. There's a tinted rock in here. Let's see, Forever Pill.
I can see forever.
That's till the end. It's kind of a waste to use it now, but we're not coming back. This is where Neptune and Lost Contact is really going to take charge, and bosses that are very projectile heavy like Delirium. And speak of the devil, there he is. We're just gonna let Pinking Shears just kind of do their thing and just harass Delirium this entire room. Man, just think of how much stronger we'd be if we had our Clot Buddy here. There you go, full damage there from a Thame. See Pinking Shears getting in there, just dealing damage. Not a lot of damage, but hey, it's damage. Okay, the body of Hollow moved through us and causes damage. So obviously, Bloody Gust and Lusty Blood helping us out big time if we do take damage, and also if we kill enemies, which Delirium does tend to spawn a lot of adds. Trying to keep down on the amount of projectiles that Delirium is going to try to throw at us. There we go. Go Sack Dagger, just bully the lad. And down he goes. So there you go. Thank you for watching, everyone. One final time, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. And put your thoughts about the name for Clot Gang down below. I'd love to see what names you all come up with in the mosh pit. Have a great start to your holiday weekend, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Bryant Pruitt, Kristen Johnson, Kelly McGuire, Simon Plockinger, and Michael McMaster. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find down below or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.